Okay, so I have two completely different solar systems installed in this house. Got the second system installed by a different company because I did not like the quality and workmanship of the first company. So the first company installed solar on the south side of the house and on the west side of the house. So that'd be the back of this house and then over to this side. Right now we're facing the north side of the house. So this is just purely my opinion to see if anyone else would agree to the quality and workmanship of the solar that's installed, or if they would personally want this type of quality on their house. So first we're gonna go in and check out the leaks on the new roof. So this is the south side of the house. So let's come down there and into the wall. And this is the master bedroom. I don't know if it shows up in the camera there, but there's damage to the ceiling that's physical, but around it it's also discolored, as well as this corner. And again, this is the south side of the house. Now, this is gonna be the west side of the house. And as you can see, there's a staining there and it's coming down enough to where it's damaging the wall. Coming into the master bath now and into the closet. Some more staining and damage to the wall. And again, this is all on the side of the first solar installer, the south and west side of the house. Now we'll actually get on the roof and see some of the issues that we have up here. So this is the second solar installer company. They did a fairly good job. No complaints there. All right, so this is the south side of the house. And as you can see, there are no end caps on the solar panel. So I can lift it right up. Same thing with this. This panel raises right up. Now I was told, oh, they'll put end caps on it, but how will you do that if the rails aren't even long enough to reach the end of the solar panels? And then coming down here, this mount, I think it's connected, right? That mount is not attached to the roof at all. Now, the other solar company and the electrical company that installed my generator, they made a point to point this out. This is directly attached to the roof with some kind of a sealant. They said, as this heats up, especially with the Texas sun, this sealant is gonna become brittle, it's gonna pull away from the shingle and the wood that's underneath that, and it will cause a leak. And that's how it's been attached to the roof everywhere, where from my research and from other solar systems I've seen in the neighborhood, they have this conduit mounted on conduit mount with flashing. All right, so the issue with the solar deck is it's installed laterally instead of vertically. They designed this with a peak up top so that the peak points up. And the reason you want the peak pointing upwards is because when it rains, that peak diverts water around the box. Here goes another solar panel. No end cap. That rail too short there. Oh, look at that. Look how much that raises. All right, so there's an end cap there, but again, the rail here. Short and raises right up. Now the cabling here on the roof, that might just be an aesthetic thing, but nowhere in the neighborhood do I see anybody else with cabling on the roof. It's run through the attic crawl space. There we go. Some panels there, also missing some end caps. Here goes another panel. I guess instead of an end cap, they figured they just kind of pinch it with this bolt here. Again, for those of who I share this video with, you guys let me know if this quality is acceptable. That solar panel here. Now this is a fire walkway and it's supposed to be a certain distance away from the hip, but as you can see, this protrudes over the hip. This was actually a lot worse on the second installation, because this is technically the third installation, because they had a panel here that actually protruded way out. It looked like a shark's fin, but I had them come out and change that up. Oh. Also, with these panel mounts, I was told, oh, these are second generation, won't leak, blah, blah, blah. So as you can see, no flashing or anything. It's just sealant and the mount. Let's take a good look at a good mount. So this is the secondary solar system. And I don't know if you can see that. Solar mount has flashing to the mount to prevent leaks. Now we'll walk around to the back of the house to get a more detailed look at some of those short railings, as well as that one that wasn't mounted. Again, here's a much better implementation of insulation. Got flashing and the mount. There's no way water's gonna get in that. But did the first solar company do that? No, they did not. So we'll just walk back through the house to the south-facing side. Get a look at that. All right, here's that one panel that we were just on the roof showing. The mount's not connected to anything. You can see that railing up there is really short and it's sagging because it has no support down there. Look how far that's sagging compared to over here where that support is. All right, and on top of that, if you look under some of these panels, there are several inverters that are just sitting on the roof. From what I understand, these should be mounted on the railing, not just laying on the roof. And there's several of these up there. So again, I ask, is this a quality you'd want personally on your roof? Is this acceptable? I'll let you be the judge. I'll have a second video when I get this all actually reinstalled, basically a repair install to do it right. And I'll take a video of that and show you the results of a properly installed system.